This is a deal.
What is good, everybody? Today we're starting the vlog here at Pearson Airport in Toronto. I'm exhausted. I've been here for the past 2 hours now. Pearson Airport's been super busy. Check-ins have been crazy, but I didn't have any problems at security. Got through with ease. Literally took like 30 seconds for everything. But I'm exhausted. Like I said, I haven't ate breakfast yet. It's currently almost 5 p.m. Flight's leaving in 2 hours, so I'm gonna try to find a restaurant before we board the gates. So let's go. I just got word that the government of Australia is going to go ahead and remove the mask mandate. So if anyone traveling within Australia doesn't have to wear a mask anymore. So I can't wait to board and get this thing off.
Bruh.
So guys, I just got to Doha, Qatar about an hour and a half ago. There was a 3+ hour delay on my flight with some mechanical failure and in-flight medical emergency. So because of that, it totally threw us off track. But luckily, I got here just in time for my flight to Melbourne. Unfortunately, I won't get a chance to use the lounge because I don't have time. So I'm actually going to my gate right now. And yeah, I'm gonna go from there. What is good and good morning from Melbourne, Australia. I'm here with the main man. It's been a while since I've been back here, almost 6 years, right?
That's it.
Yeah, but we're here. A lot has changed as far as the city goes. Currently, it is just past 7 a.m. We're gonna go have some breakfast, and then today's the bachelor day. Today's the big day. So yeah, we'll see what today has in store. So let's go.
Unless you have a valid exemption. Thank you for your support and stay safe.
So this is the streetcar system, aka the tram here in Melbourne. I think I showed you guys a little bit of this back when I vlogged here 6 years ago. But of course the city has developed a lot since then. Don't worry guys, we're gonna be exploring. We're gonna be exploring a lot. Still quite early, so
yep.
On a Sunday. So I'm not seeing a lot of people out yet, but it'll fill up quick. So guys, I didn't get a chance to record while I landed in Australia because number one, it was super busy at the airport. Number two, baggage claims just took forever for my flight. And number three, I was randomly selected. But anyway, everything was good, all is well. I got out of there, we got to the spot, had some dinner, and then just ended the night. So we're at, what's this place called? Brunetti?
Brunetti.
We're at Brunetti. It's a very bougie, fancy cafe where they serve breakfast, lunch, dinner, and of course the espressos, coffees. This is actually going to be my first time trying an espresso here, a latte, in Australia. So
here we go.
We'll see how that goes. yeah, so this is how we're starting our day off today. So we got our breakfast, we got our lattes, about to get our grub on. That was bomb. How was it? Rate it.
Really good.
Out of 10.
11 out of 10.
Yeah, it was good. That was amazing. We'll definitely check it out again.
I've got to mention this in my vlog.
So guys, just like last time I was here, what I've been doing is I keep looking towards the left side when I'm crossing. I got to get my mind right and look towards the right side. Otherwise, I'm going to end up getting hit by a car.
Yeah. See,
it's been bad. It's been bad. I've been trying to get used to it since last night, but it's been bad so far, guys. So guys, unlike last time, this time we're actually gonna explore the city more, try out new restaurants and different places that we didn't get a chance to do last time I was here. This time we're definitely gonna get a chance to do that. So recommendations, whatever the case is, shoot away, man.
And I'll take him any way you want, anyway.
Yes sir, yes sir. Okay. Looking at the right side this time.
We shouldn't have crossed, it was the red line.
So guys, we're actually headed right now to grab a SIM card and adapter charger for the conversion and a dress shirt.
Yep.
Yeah. A few things for today. It's still pretty early in the morning. A lot of stuff is not open as of yet, but we got about 10-15 minutes to kill. Oh, by the way, this is what the popo cars look like here
in Melbourne. Blue and white. That's state police.
Yeah.
The federal's the red.
Guys, we're cutting through Chinatown.
It's Spadina 2.0.
Spadina 2.0 for those that live in Toronto. There's a bunch of alleyways here. There's a bunch of restaurants here. I'm actually walking on the road. I don't know if I'm walking on the right side or not. I mean, this is a one-way, so it doesn't really matter.
It's a one-way.
No hook turns.
But as you can see, it's pretty quiet right now. It's still early. Anyway, guys, we're going to go get the stuff and then go home, get ready, change, and we're gonna get ready for the bachelors. So guys, we were just at Big W, which is like their Walmart, and I got this $30 starter pack SIM card, $21 off, so it's for $9, 55 gigs. That's honestly amazing. In Canada, you're freaking getting robbed. You're paying for 55 gigs, you're paying close to 100 plus. So that's amazing.
$9 including tax.
Including tax. So guys, we're here in the condo, getting ready for the bachelors. And we got the main bachelor right over here.
What's that we doing?
What's that we doing?
What are your thoughts?
I don't know.
Did you get that?
Yeah. All right guys, so we're headed to the meetup spot now with all the other boys. This is gonna be fun. Here we go. So we're walking in the city right now, guys.
Yeah.
We're going at like 7-8 people just staring, looking at us like, what the fuck is going on?
What is going on? There's something big happening. Something big is going
to
happen.
So we're headed to Federation Square to meet up with all the other boys. Bachelor party starts now.
It starts now.
Give me your thoughts. Huh? What are you feeling right now?
I feel embarrassed.
That's an understatement.
I feel embarrassed. It's one of the most embarrassing things I've had to. We're in the middle of the city, and I have to dress up like this shit. And we're gonna get on the tram. People are looking at me.
Everybody's just like, what the hell is going on?
You know, I mean, this is catching a tram.
We're going down this way?
Oh man, let's get on the tram and let's just hide. I'm in hide mode. I'm in hide mode at the moment.
Where is it, this one or this one?
That one there. That's right, Serena Williams coming.
I actually really want to see what the other guys are wearing, because that's just going to be, it's going to be funny.
Don't worry, Serena Williams coming.
My outfit is also with one of the boys, so we'll see.
Can we just start waving at people?
Only if they stare, you know?
Yeah. Sorry, Williams. So like, what the hell are you doing?
Like, what is he on Sunday morning? So guys, this section of the vlog is sponsored by
Sprite. Because this is what Serena Williams wanted before she retired. Lost.
So we're 2 minutes out. Final thoughts?
Serena Williams lost.
So you said if they're not dressed up, what are you gonna do?
I'm just gonna be, I'll be pissed off. Well, I don't know. I'm hoping they're dressed up. I've got a change of clothes and I'm ready to get changed. Cause I'm walking down the middle of the city like Serena Williams.
Sponsored by Sprite?
Sponsored by Sprite.
But we'll see, we're like 2 minutes out, so we'll see what happens.
Let's go.
What's going on?
Hey, bro, how you doing?
How are you, man?
Have you been?
Good. How are you, man?
Yeah, I'm good.
I'm a bit shocked.
How's it going?
Serena, is that you?
Serena.
Yeah.
It is too.
We got the main man here.
This guy looks like.
How do you feel?
Oh, feel pretty tight.
You get that?
I feel tight.
The boy's here.
Lovely.
Yeah, thank you. We thought brother.
What happened?
We're gonna meet you there. Can you walk down here?
Yeah. Like 5 minutes. Yeah, cause I was calling you guys, but the Wi-Fi is pretty shit. I didn't get a chance to put my SIM card in yet. So we're here with the boys.
Hey.
And the sponsored by Sprite.
I keep saying it. Got Serena Williams people. Yep.
No, guys, he didn't lose a bet. He did not lose a bet.
We did not lose a bet at all.
So I told him the full disclosure. Jordan and Byron were the ones that came up with the idea. And then I told Saz, I'm like, hey, look, man, we're all getting dressed up. They got my outfit, too. He's like...
I thought you guys were getting dressed up. This is the biggest job of all time.
He's like, when I go there, if they're not dressed up, I'm going to be pissed off.
If guys are not dressed up, what am I doing?
Hey, Stars, congratulations. You've just been set on one big fool's errand.
Yeah. It's not even April Fool's. It's like September Fool's.
Pretty much. Yeah, pretty much.
But here's the plus side. He's got a change of clothes, so if we happen to get kicked out, we can change clothes. Go away.
It's September 11th, it's a stitch up.
Guys, we're at event number one. Unfortunately, there's no cameras allowed inside, but we'll let you know how it goes.
Alright, sure. Alright. Well, I gotta say, like, this is my first time ever doing a skate room. It really gets you thinking. You gotta have your thinking caps on. You know, correct. Like there was a whole squad of us. So it makes everything easy. Like, it makes everything a lot easier when you're doing a whole entire squad. But honestly, like.
We did it with 22 minutes to spare, or a little bit more, I think.
Yeah.
So within 40 minutes of time.
I can just imagine doing this by yourself. That would be really hard. Or if you're doing it with like two or three other people. Yeah, doing it. Like just the amount of the numberings or the codes that you have to.
And it actually challenges you as well. So that was good.
Oh, it sure does. Like it's and as I said, this is my first ever experience, and I'll definitely be doing this again.
Yeah.
And I think some of you guys have done this before.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not here, obviously.
Even though like you've done this before, like you know what to expect.
It's always different. That's the thing. It's unique. Every escape room has their own style.
Yeah.
So yeah, some of them are very obvious. Some of them are not. So, guys, scale 1 to 10. How was it?
Pretty good.
That was pretty good.
One out of 10. I'd say the experience was
9 out of 10.
I really enjoyed it.
Compared to other escape rooms, I found the challenge a lot harder, in a good way.
Yeah.
I like the fact that we had to interact with each other between ourselves. The ambiance of the place was really nice, like the lighting and everything was a lot darker, getting us handcuffed at the start.
Yeah, really good.
If you guys want to check it out here in Melbourne, it's called Adventure Rooms.
Adventure Rooms.
Adventure Rooms.
So guys, one thing that really confuses me about Melbourne is the hook turns. The hook turns really confuse me.
Okay.
What are your thoughts on that?
We get people coming into Melbourne and then they have no understanding hook turns. Hook turns is a quite it's a decision.
I saw that. I was like, what the hell is going on? The guy literally goes into the middle and he doesn't turn and then he just goes whoop.
look, when I first got my driver's license when I was 19 years old, I had to learn hook turns, and I was asking myself, okay, how do I do this shit? How do I do this shit?
You don't let the guy right. Yeah. What's on the stand?
Yeah. Well, I even it's quite an acquired skill. All right, basically, you're hook turns in a nutshell is you are following two traffic lights.
Can you do hook turns?
All right, so first, you go to screen, and then you turn in a hook motion. But when the other road lights turn green, then you turn and go. So you're merging with the next traffic.
It's to avoid the trams.
Aussie.
Oi.
So here
in Melbourne, while you're waiting for the next lights to go green, you just sip on your soy latte while you're waiting.
Pricks
do that.
Exactly.
Interesting.
It's a star, I swear.
We're at event number 2. Ballers Clubhouse. Let's get it.
If the pressure affects you clear first, some people get motivated by that.
What is good, everybody? Last night we got so lit. It was so much fun that I actually forgot to end the vlog. So we're gonna go ahead and do that right now. Thank you so much for watching. Shout out to this guy back here, Staz. It was his bachelor's wedding is coming up in a few days now. So I will do my best to try and record that if I can, because I'm gonna be up there with him as his best man. But if I can't, we will still put a little bit of footage on. I'll try to put a little bit of footage on from cell phone maybe. And we'll go from there. But stay tuned for more Aussie vlogs. See you guys next time. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch you guys later. 21, can you do something for me? 21. Can you hit a little rich flex for me? 21. Then 21, can you do something for me? 21.